Hello, everyone. Welcome to another episode of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. Today, we're going to do things differently. We are going to talk about how Microsoft is building all these different products, but how we really put these things together to make our customers' journey easy and seamless. That's exactly what we want to focus on today's episode. And I have none other than Andy Beatman, who is the Director of Product Marketing for Azure AI Foundry. Andy, I would love to introduce yourself, but then I also want you to focus on what does product marketing mean to you?
Absolutely. Well, thanks for having me, first of all. And hey, everyone. My name is Andy Beatman, Director of Product Marketing with Azure AI Foundry. And being a Director of Product Marketing means I'm effectively a CMO of a product. And I get to think about everything from how we bring the product to market, what's the positioning, the messaging, how do we activate customers to help us tell the story, how they're using the products, going to events and evangelizing those products, and really just making sure the world knows, developers care, and we start seeing enterprises build with those products. So I love that as a PMM, it's art and science. I get to think about how I make customers perceive and feel about Azure and Foundry and the AI products and tools. And I also get to help teams have the resources to go build things quickly.
That's amazing, Andy. Now, I see the world is talking about AI all the time. Since probably a couple of years, we have been hearing AI more than ever. It's not like AI just got out of the blue, but somehow it has become very prevalent in all our daily life and activities. Probably 2-3 years, we've been hearing a lot more of AI. I would want you to demystify for all of us on what is AI? Does every organization really need AI, or is it just a buzzword?
I love that question because I meet with customers on a regular basis, and AI is not new. In fact, AI has been around over 50 years. But with the introduction of tools that you can touch or talk to, like ChatGPT, Copilot, it's enabled everyone to have a perspective on AI. So when things are accessible, that means that culture can shift and people feel like they are in control of that tech destiny when it comes to technology. So AI is not new, but AI, in terms of everyone being able to use it and understand it, it is. And that's a beautiful thing. It also creates expectations. Now that everybody understands what it is, there's a focus on what it can do. And can it do it safely, and can it do it reliably? So that's a big focus, right? And for me, I'm all about not just what is the AI strategy for a business or for a developer, but what is your business strategy? And can AI help fit the needs of those use cases? So AI first. Some companies are born in AI and only using AI to run their company. You're seeing agentic executives. But you're also seeing companies that are saying, wait, I want to look at AI as a way to continue to build my business. So it's business first and AI as a complement to the existing strategies.
Absolutely. Now, I know you own a lot of products within the AI space. Can you talk to us about what is Azure AI Foundry? And how does that fit into the whole AI spectrum?
Okay, so great. You want to go build an AI application, or you want to modernize your existing application with AI. You need an end-to-end place to do that. And Azure AI Foundry is that place. You can build a multi-agent orchestration to automate workflows. You can count on observability and evaluations to make sure that the models and the agents are running as you'd expect. You have built-in safety features like content safety filters, so you can configure things like violence or any inappropriate themes that you wouldn't want to see happen in your experience. You're able to connect Foundry to the Microsoft and Azure ecosystem, Cosmos DB, Fabric, and even extend to the world beyond, like knowledge sources that go out of the ecosystem, like building an agent using Morningstar Research or TripAdvisor as well. So thinking end-to-end, thinking scale, thinking safety, but really the beauty is the integration with the existing stack. That's what I think is the most exciting thing.
I love that because, see, Microsoft as a company, it's not really producing products and services here and there, but they're really thinking through from a customer journey perspective. They're taking a step back. Apparently, I guess, when all these big heads really sit in a room, they're not just siloed. So we talk about data silos, think about product silos from an organization like Microsoft. They're not doing that. They're really trying to integrate all these different products and how well they can work together. And that's exactly what you're referring to, right, Andy?
Yeah, well, I think I would, internally at Microsoft, we like to say better together. But I think that's a great expression to say externally as well. But that has to have product truth. We talk about synergy, integrations. Developers want to see that when they go into the Foundry. So if you don't find lots of ways to integrate easily into the system, it can get frustrating because now you're building in a silo. So yes, I've been in many discussions where we're thinking about an amazing feature, but then we ask the hard question of, well, how does that feature impact messaging and positioning for a similar product in the Microsoft stack? So it's really important to give developers choice, but also to give them guidance on what's best for whatever they're trying to do.
Wonderful. Now, I understand AI, how Azure AI Foundry fits into the whole AI ecosystem, how different products within Microsoft talk to each other. But tell me a little more about Copilot. Where does Copilot come into play?
Well, first of all, Copilot is almost ubiquitous now at Microsoft. We think about every application, GitHub Copilot, M365 Copilot, Security Copilot. There's that expectation now that you have this assistant with you to help you understand what you're doing and provide recommendations. So when we think about Copilot, we have to sort of take a step back to our investment in OpenAI and bringing that technology to our own products, testing those products internally. We love eating our dog food, and then bringing those package technologies to our customers and partners.
That's wonderful. Now, here at Fabric Tech Talk Fridays, Andy, we just don't do the talk. We walk the talk. So let's get to your laptop and show us what you got. Do you have a demo that really, because it is too good to be true in some cases, but how does Microsoft Fabric and Azure AI Foundry really work together? Do you have a demo that we can see in action?
Yeah, I have a demo, but before we jump in the demo, I just want to drive home a few points because I say better together. I talk about just the fact that at Microsoft, if you're a customer and you're using our products together, there's often better things and ways you can go bigger. And for me, when I think about Azure AI Foundry and Fabric, I think about two things. One, I think about the cliche of there's no AI without data. And if you don't have your data in a great place, then it's going to be really difficult to build AI. But I would also say once you've built with AI, the need for continuous improvement and optimization is so critical. So you have new data now that you've built a multi-agent orchestration, and you need Fabric to not just ingest and help analyze, but also go for deeper insights. Mm-hmm. So you can go back to those development teams and say, hey, we have some great ideas on how the next multi-agent orchestration can be better, or to the existing one as well. And the second point I want to make before we dive into the demo is just an example. I want to make this more real. Mm-hmm. You're a financial services company. You build a multi-agent orchestration. The first agent is all about fraud detection and making sure that transactions as they happen are as they should be. The second could be a personal product recommendation agent. So as you're seeing what customers are doing, you're recommending them new products or even going deeper into trade recommendations or investments. And then having a third agent on compliance. So making sure that the bank and everything they're doing is compliant as well. And those agents all talk to each other. But what happens there, right? You're observing the performance of the agents in Foundry, but you're using Fabric to analyze the performance and how it impacts everything else. So for me, if I'm building a multi-agent orchestration, yeah, I want to be observing how those models and the agents are performing, but I really want to talk to the team that's looking at Fabric and understanding the deeper insights to how those agents are performing, and then potentially, what are the next series of agents for that bank that can actually help it operate smoother and drive way more value for institutional and retail customers. So let's jump into the demo. Our friend Tyler from Security has put together an amazing demo that I think you all should see and help really illustrate just the power of Fabric and Foundry together.
Let's get back to our friends at Contoso Outdoors, who are building a data foundation for their AI solutions. The Contoso team has already started to build a lakehouse out in Microsoft Fabric. So let's jump in and take a look. As a data engineer, I'm going to use one lake catalog within Fabric to quickly find any data assets that I need. I'm going to filter down by lakehouses and open up our Contoso lakehouse. From here, I can see tables, permissions, recent activity, and a full end-to-end data lineage. The data lineage view gives us a visual representation of data that's being brought into our lakehouse, transformations that occur, semantic models that are built on top, and any reports and notebooks that are consuming the data. In our case here, we can see that there's a pipeline bringing in customer data and a real-time stream of inventory updates from Microsoft Fabric Real-Time Intelligence. Let's open up the lakehouse, take a look at the data. First thing I notice is Fabric has proactively flagged a potential risk. We can see that it's flagged the risk and marked the data as being highly confidential. Going into the details, I can see that it found credit card data that was brought in through our pipeline. So let's remove this data before we continue. I've got a notebook that's already open that can help us by removing this column of data. After running the Spark notebook, we can go back to our lakehouse, refresh the data, and I can see that the credit card column has been removed, that Fabric has removed the warning, and we can now reclassify the sensitivity labeling as general, which enables it to be used by our agent. Now we have most of what we need, but we're still missing product images and description information. I could build a pipeline to bring that data in. I could use Fabric mirroring to replicate that data from an operational source, or I could build a shortcut, which enables the data to be available in Fabric without having to move the data. Because our product information is in an AWS S3 bucket, I'm going to create a new shortcut. I specify S3 bucket, provide the connection information, select the data we'd like, and once created, that data is immediately available within Fabric. I can click on the data, verify it has what we need. We now have our data foundation built. As an AI developer, I'm going to jump into Azure AI Foundry, which we saw earlier, to test out our AI solution on top of this data. We've already connected this to a GPT-40 model. We've made our lakehouse data available, and we're going to use the Foundry chat playground to test this out. Let's start by asking a question our customer would typically ask, like what is the best sleeping bag for winter camping? The response we can see is contextualized to our data within the lakehouse. I can also click on references to get details about the specific data that back that up. So within a few minutes, we saw how easy it is to use Microsoft Fabric to fuel our agentic AI solutions.
Now that was cool, right? Let's just think about some of the key points that I would take away from what we were talking about before in the demo too. That coming back to better together. So one, just that end-to-end lifecycle, being able to build a multi-agent orchestration that's safe in Foundry and analyze and get deeper insights in Fabric. The real-time feedback loop, I think that's always really important for teams, is not just analyzing a retrospective, but being able to go in and understand what's happening now. Unified security, there's no AI or data story without security.
Absolutely.
So that's like the backbone of our company and everything that we do. Celebrating 50 years of Microsoft is celebrating 50 years of security. And scalable modular architecture as well, being able to easily build agents in Foundry and test those agents and then go into Fabric and have a really easy way to look at the data. And then finally, just continuous improvement. The continuous improvement, I mean, at an individual level, we should always be trying to find ways to improve within our business environments. It's looking at our projects and then, of course, helping understand operational value too. So all of that, by the way, leads me to this feeling of you may come for the AI. You may come for the generative AI platform. You may come to test the new reasoning model. But you're going to stay for the platform because that's where the value is the total cost of ownership in building AI in Azure, being able to connect it to Fabric, store data, be able to execute responsible AI without even thinking about it because it's baked in, and of course, experiment across the Microsoft stack. It's just a developer's dream. So that's for me where, yes, I love the products that I work on, but I am more excited about seeing customers take advantage of everything within the stack that we offer.
That's amazing, Andy. So if there is one key takeaway that you would like to leave today, what would that be?
Well, I think just being curious is probably one of my favorite mantras in life. Even partnering together, better together, partnering together, there's a level of curiosity because I need to dive deep into the Fabric ecosystem to think really about what this means for my customers mm-hmm. and the Foundry side. Mm-hmm. So my takeaway would be to remain curious and to remain focused on not getting to a place that you say, okay, I now get it, but really thinking about the fact that we should remain always curious, because each time that something is released, and yes, we're releasing products and technology at an unbelievable pace, it actually allows us to potentially realize our vision even sooner. And I think that's what makes me most excited, is that we are just getting started. So while yes, we have 50 years of AI and machine learning, we have just a few years of generative AI and data together, which means we're onto something. It's just the beginning. So I'm really excited to see where this goes.
No, that's a really good takeaway. Andy, see, what we would love our customers to do is, just like you said, come for the services, but stay for the platform, because it's truly an end-to-end platform. Whether you are starting your data journey or data estate, or you're coming for the AI, you've got it all, from databases to AI to SaaS platform like Microsoft Fabric. So it's all in there. Just take advantage of all the wonderful work that Microsoft is putting in together.
And by the way, like we talk about the Microsoft ecosystem, but there's a world where agents are talking to other agents that are built by other cloud providers mm-hmm. and hyperscalers. So MCP, A2A, this open protocol, that's also really becoming critical mm-hmm. because we know that not all customers are working with one cloud shop. And in many cases, even if they are, you recognize that there is a massive and diverse ecosystem. So making sure that the technologies can communicate, the agents can talk, and regardless of who built those agents, where they're coming from, there's seamless integration. And that's, to me, where everything is critical, because if we're not seeing that communication between systems, then those systems break. So I love the fact that the technology world has really centered around more open protocol, which, by the way, is integrated in Microsoft's history mm-hmm. of making sure that developers have the ability to go into a GitHub repo and contribute. So the future is much more flexible for those that were building it and part of it.
No, amazing. Thank you so much for hanging out with us today, Andy. Really appreciate all the insights. Thanks again. Thank you everyone for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget to hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you would like to see on the future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric.